What's up guys, Sal here. So when Apple announced the transition to its own Apple Silicon chips for its new Mac line, few could have imagined the extent of praise and plaudits that followed the release of the hardware. The M1 chip has practically unmatched performance while being shockingly affordable. The chip has put Apple in a powerful position, and while that may be great for Apple, it's also great for us. Why? Because it serves as added competition that will force Intel to get its head back in the game, which will encourage AMD to keep innovating, and also will force the likes of Samsung, Qualcomm, and even Google to make an ARM chipset that could rival this M1 chip. And that's kind of what we're hearing today on Samsung's side. There's a new report from a big South Korean publication that claims Samsung is working on its own Exynos branded rival that'll be used across even more devices. According to an industry insider, the new Exynos will offer improved function, including extraordinary computing power and battery efficiency by utilizing a 5-nanometer process technology. It's good for both laptops and smartphones. He mentioned that Samsung will use AMD graphics on this new chipset and will make it available in the second half of this year. Initially, Samsung is expected to use it inside a Windows-powered laptop, but eventually the chipset use will be expanded to other devices including their smartphones and tablets. With that said, while I'm happy that there is finally some good competition in the silicon space which will surely benefit consumers, but I highly doubt Samsung would surpass Apple's M1 chip in raw power and efficiency. Yes, they might come close to Apple's A series of chipset in both CPU and GPU judging from the leaked benchmark scores, but I doubt they would be able to do that with the M1 chip. And the reason for that is it's just plain hard to beat a well-designed in-house chip. Apple knows how to make a great in-house chipset. Yes, Samsung has been trying for years with their Exynos lineup, but there's a problem with theirs. You see, Samsung isn't Google, or in other words, they don't own Android or Windows like Microsoft. Because of Apple's M1 chip, Apple now manufacture pretty much everything that goes into their devices. They now design their own software and all of the hardware, including the processor. While Samsung may manufacture all of their hardware, they can't optimize Android as well as Google does, or as well as Apple optimizes iOS. So it's gonna be hard for Samsung or Qualcomm to make a chip that could go toe-to-toe with the M1. But the good thing for these companies is that Apple is still using A series chipsets on their phones, and they aren't quite as powerful as M1, which means the Exynos chipset with AMD graphics has all the potential to be the top smartphone chip available when it finally launches later in the year. But then again, the thing that makes the M1 chip great is that Apple can basically put it into any device they want to. This chip isn't only limited to laptops and desktops, meaning that it could also be used for mobile phones. Now that Apple has put this chip in the iPad Pro, there's pretty much nothing stopping them from putting this chip in a future iPhone, which could potentially lead to better longevity, better battery life, and would place it even further ahead of the competition. So Apple has made it really difficult for other OEMs to catch up, but like I've said, this will only make Samsung, Qualcomm, Intel, and AMD keep innovating, and as a result, we as the consumers also win. Do consider subscribing for all the latest tech news, and as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.